Today we will start the Fourier series for discontinuous function. As we know that Fourier series for a continuous function or a periodic function, the value of the Fourier coefficient a0, an, and bn is different from for discontinuous function. So what is a discontinuous function? Discontinuous function is a function whose value is not continuous at any particular point. So we have considered that there is a function which is defined as function fx, f is equal to f1x in the interval c2x0, and its value is f2x in the interval x0 to c plus 2 pi. So the value, the continuity point, discontinuous point is x is equal to x0, where x0 is the point of discontinuity in the interval c to c plus 2 pi. 2 pi is the period of this function. So in such cases, the Fourier series for fx and its coefficient is given by a0 is equal to 1 by pi c2 x0 f1x, and then x0 to c plus 2 pi f2x dx. Similarly, the coefficient of an, that is Fourier second coefficient, is 1 by pi c2 x0 f1x into cos nx dx. And in the second interval, x0 to c plus 2 pi f2x cos nx dx. Similarly, the coefficient, third coefficient bn, is equal to 1 by pi c2 x0 f1x sin nx dx. And in the second interval, it is x0 to c plus 2 pi f2x cos, sorry, it is sin, here it will be sin, sin nx dx. So if x is equal to x0 in the point of finite discontinuity, then the sum of the Fourier series is equal to half limit s tends to 0, left hand limit plus right hand limit, that is x0 minus h plus limit h is equal to 0, x0 plus h. Similarly, this can be written as 1 by 2 f of x0 minus 0 plus f of x0 plus 0. And this value will be given from this graph here, a to b. The value of the function is f1x, x is equal to x0 is the discontinuous point or discontinuity point, and c to d, the value of the function is f2x. So this value will be half of f of b and then f of c. F of b is the value of the function f1x, and f of c is the value of function in f2x. So this is the Fourier series for discontinuous function. Now we will study about the odd and even function. Derive the Fourier series for odd and even function. So first we will define what is even function. So a function is said to be even, or sometimes it is also called symmetric function, if f of minus of x is equal to fx. For example, cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta, or cos of minus of x is equal to cos x. So cos or cosines angles are even functions. But sine of minus theta is equal to minus sine theta. Therefore, sine is not an even function. Its value is minus, so it is not an even function. Also, there is a property that f of minus x plus f of x is equal to 2 times fx. Since the value of f of minus x is equal to fx, and fx is already fx, so fx plus fx is equal to 2 times fx. Also, the graph of such function is symmetrical with respect to the y-axis, and the area under such a curve from minus pi to plus pi is double the area from 0 to pi. It is also proved, this can also be proved from the property of the definite integral, that is minus pi to plus pi. If we change the limit from 0 to pi, from the property of definite integral, it is 2 times f of fx. So using this property, and this is the graph of the even function, so using the property of this, we can derive the Fourier coefficient for even function. So as we know that a naught is equal to, here the limit is minus pi to plus pi, so it is a naught 1 by pi minus pi to plus pi fx dx, and here using this property, so it will be 0 to pi 2 times, so 2 by pi fx dx. Similarly, the value of an is equal to 1 by pi minus pi to plus pi fx cos nx dx. Here cos is an even function. Also, we have shown there that it is, cos is also a even function. The product of two even function is also even. So it is 2 times, using this property, 2 by pi 0 to pi fx cos nx dx. But in the case of pn, 1 by pi minus pi to plus pi fx sin nx plus into dx is equal to 0, because here fx is a even function, but sin nx is not an even function, it is an odd function, and the product of even and odd is odd, so its value will be 0. So in even function, there is only two Fourier coefficients, that is a naught and an. Now next, we will derive similar derivation for odd function. We will see what is odd function. So a function is said to be a odd or skew symmetric function if f of minus of x is equal to minus of fx. So sine of minus of theta is equal to minus sine theta, so sine is an odd function. Also, f of minus x minus fx is equal to 0, because the value of f of minus x for odd function is plus, is f of minus x plus fx, and this result will give the value 0. The graph of odd function is just different from the even function, and the area under minus pi to plus pi fx dx is equal to 0. So if we calculate the value of a naught, that is Fourier coefficient for the odd function, it is 1 by pi minus pi to plus pi fx dx is equal to 0, because using this result, the value is 0. Similarly, an, 1 by pi minus pi to plus pi fx cos nx dx, because it is an odd function, it is an even function, so multiplication is odd, so it will give the value 0. But in the case of bn, 1 by pi minus pi to pi fx sin x dx, its value is 2 by pi 0 to pi, because it is fx, here it is odd function, sin nx is odd function, odd into odd is even function. So even function, using the property of even function which we have discussed earlier, it is 2 times 2 by pi 0 to pi fx sin nx dx. So in the case of odd function, a naught is equal to 0, an is equal to 0, just we have to calculate the value of b naught bn, and this is for odd function. And for even function, an is there, but bn is equal to 0. So by checking the result or the problem, that is the given function is odd or even, we can easily calculate or expand the given function with the help of Fourier series and Fourier coefficient.